Today we will study about viral conjunctivitis. Viral conjunctivitis. Most of the viral infections tend to affect the epithelium, both of the conjunctiva and cornea. So, the typical viral lesion is a keratoconjunctivitis. In some viral infections, conjunctival involvement is more prominent. Example, pharyngeoconjunctival fever. While in others, cornea is more involved. Example, herpes simplex. Viral infections of conjunctiva include adenovirus conjunctivitis, herpes simplex keratoconjunctivitis, herpes zoster conjunctivitis, molluscum contagiosum conjunctivitis, pox virus conjunctivitis, myxovirus conjunctivitis, paramyxovirus conjunctivitis, and Arbor virus conjunctivitis. Clinical presentation of acute viral conjunctivitis include acute follicular conjunctivitis and acute hemorrhagic conjunctivitis. Adenoviral conjunctivitis. Adenoviruses are the commonest causes of viral conjunctivitis. These are non-enveloped double-stranded DNA viruses, which replicate within the nucleus of the host cells. General reservoir of adenoviruses is only human. Types of adenoviral conjunctivitis include epidemic keratoconjunctivitis, non-specific acute follicular conjunctivitis, pharyngeoconjunctival fever, and chronic relapsing adenoviral conjunctivitis. In this video, we will see the details about epidemic keratoconjunctivitis, that is EKC. It is a type of acute follicular conjunctivitis, mostly associated with superficial punctate keratitis and usually occurs in epidemics. Hence, the name EKC, that is epidemic keratoconjunctivitis. Etiology of epidemic keratoconjunctivitis. Epidemic keratoconjunctivitis is mostly caused by adenoviruses type 8 and 19. The condition is markedly contagious and spreads through contact with contaminated fingers, solutions, and tonometers. Clinical features. Incubation period after infection is about 8 days and virus is shed from the inflamed eye for 2 to 3 weeks. Symptoms. Symptoms are similar to severe form of acute catarrhal conjunctivitis and include redness of sudden onset associated with watering, usually profuse with mild mucoid discharge, ocular discomfort and foreign body sensation, photophobia, usually mild, becomes marked when cornea is involved. Signs. Eyelids are swollen, causing narrowing of palpebral aperture. Conjunctival signs are hyperemia is usually marked and prominent. Chemosis of conjunctiva is often present. Follicles of small to moderate size, typically involving the lower fornix and palpebral conjunctiva, form the characteristic feature. Papillary reaction may also be seen in many cases. Petechial subconjunctival hemorrhages may be seen in severe adenoviral conjunctivitis. Pseudomembrane lining the lower fornix and palpebral conjunctiva may be formed in about 3% patients with severe inflammation. Corneal involvement occurs in about 80% of cases and is characterized by the following lesions. Epithelial microcytic diffuse, fine, non-staining lesions are common during the early stage. Superficial punctate keratitis, SPK, a typical feature of epidemic keratoconjunctivitis, usually occurs after 10 days of onset of symptoms and lasts for about 3 weeks, even after subsidence of conjunctival inflammation. Subepithelial infiltrates may develop under the focal epithelial lesion in 20-50% of cases. These opacities may be initially disabling and may persist for months to years. Preauricular lymphadenopathy is associated with almost all cases of epidermic keratoconjunctivitis. Differential diagnosis. Epidermic keratoconjunctivitis needs to be differentiated from other causes of acute follicular conjunctivitis, which include other types of adenoviral keratoconjunctivitis such as non-specific acute follicular conjunctivitis and pharyngeoconjunctival fever. Acute hemorrhagic conjunctivitis, herpes simplex virus conjunctivitis, systemic viral infections such as herpes zoster conjunctivitis, measles, mumps, and chikungunya virus conjunctivitis, and adult inclusion conjunctivitis. Investigations. Investigations are required mainly for research purposes and in some non-resolving cases, and include conjunctival psychology with GIMSA stain shows predominantly mononuclear cells in adenoviral conjunctivitis and multinucleated giant cells in herpetic conjunctivitis. Polymerase chain reaction, that is PCR test, is sensitive and specific for viral DNA. Point of care immunochromatography test takes only 10 minutes to detect adenoviral antigens in tears and have excellent sensitivity and specificity. Viral cultures are tedious and time consuming with variable sensitivity but 100% specificity. Treatment. Supportive treatment like cold compressors and sunglasses to decrease glare, decongestant and lubricant tear drops to decrease discomfort can be used along with our homeopathic medicines. Prevention. It is very important as the adenoviral conjunctivitis is highly contagious and patients may be infectious for up to 11 days after onset. Transmission usually occurs from eye to finger to eyes. Tonometers, contact lenses, and eye drops are other routes of transmission. Preventive measures include frequent hand washing, relative isolation of infected individual, avoiding eye rubbing and common use of towel or handkerchief sharing. Disinfection of ophthalmic instruments and clinical surfaces after examination of a patient is also essential.
Thank you and see you in the next class. Bye-bye.